Hello everyone and welcome to this video. Today we ask the question of, is Mirissa worth visiting? So let me go ahead and try to interest you with some clips I took on my one day stay at Mirissa. And to start things off, let's go ahead and check out the room we stayed at. Now I want to mention that I thought it was a good idea to take a video of the room the next day, so here's just a short clip I took which was purely meant for testing purposes. And not to point out any fingers, but someone puked in the sink for some reason, even though the toilet was literally right there, and a bit on the floor as well. So because of that, the plan to take a video of the room the next day instantly disappeared, like all the girls I tried to talk to.
I can edit it if there are two important parts. Alright, let's go. Don't shout like a body, step number one.
Okay everyone, now we're going to be going and eating at some place. Somewhere here, hopefully it's a cheap place. This place is called Fresh Wave and the rooms we stayed at cost roughly 6,800. And you can fit about 4 people into one room as you saw before, therefore potentially bringing each of your costs down to 1,700 for a night. Now the rooms are not the best and I know I didn't film the bathroom, but trust me when I say it's hideous. The outside of the place itself, it's quite nice and I got to mention the super friendly staff as well. Awesome group of people. I mean, they didn't even say anything when we left the place, kinda messed up the next day. Now off we go to what brought us here in the first place, and that of course is the beautiful Mirissa beach, so let's check that out. There's also a swing over there. I wonder if
you wanna try?
Yeah, shall we?
I wish like you could land into the water, you know?
Yeah.
But that's not, you know, fine.
That'd be awesome. I decided to just walk along the beach and check out that interesting looking island over there. Now I'm sure you must be wondering, what is it called, right? Maybe Pirate Island, Treasure Island, but don't worry, it's none of those, it's even better. Okay? It's called Rock Island. Rock Island. I mean, it's very, very logical. You see a rock and it's on an island, so you put it together and you get Rock Island. It's straight to the point and that's what I like about it. So dark clouds started to appear and us not having any waterproof phones, you can pretty much imagine what happens next.
So it just started to rain and we've got our phones with us. So we have to get back as soon as possible.
We ran to the first place we found and decided to just have our breakfast from there. From the looks of things, the breakfast seems to be quite the same in most other places as well. Now what we got was a continental breakfast meal which does include either a fruit drink or just fruits by themselves, toasted bread, eggs made to your specifications, and finally tea or coffee. The price of this being around 600 rupees. How's the drink?
It's good.
It's really good.
Out of 10?
8.5. 8.5, not bad. How about you?
6.5.
High standards,
he has
huh?
Low standards. Low standards.
After having our meal, we have to ask the question of, was it worth the money we paid for? There was nothing wrong with the food. I mean, of course, how can you screw up some eggs and toast, right? But you have to realize that the ingredients they used are relatively cheap. And what we paid for it was definitely overpriced. With the dark clouds still looming above us, my friends wanted to check out this place called Coconut Hills, which is really famous because you can take some awesome Instagram-worthy pictures there. And that is where we headed next.
This is the perfect place for a thumbnail. And here we are at Coconut Hills. Yay! Now time to get back to the hotel. Let's go.
Let's go. Harold the proof.
Harold proofs, yay. Go Harold.
Coconut Hill is progressive. You don't know.
Yeah.
Yes, I just skipped to the next day because the clouds didn't seem to want to go away and the camera really sucks with low light. So the footage I took was just too bad to show. But the night itself was pretty fun. Before we got dressed to dance at some beach club, we had fun in the ocean while it was raining the whole time. I don't think the lifeguards liked us at all. Afterwards, we had some dinner at the place we stayed at, and they were serving freshly caught fish and prawns. And we got to choose which fish we wanted to eat from their selection of fish they had. After eating and drinking, we just went and danced the night away. Today we decided to finally check out the mysterious looking rock island and see what adventure it holds. So off we went. After checking this place out, we just had our breakfast, spent time in the ocean some more and just left. So was Mirissa worth visiting? Well, I have to say apart from the kinda overpriced food, yes, the location was great, the beach was even better. So if you're planning on going somewhere, I would recommend checking this place out. Okay everyone, I hope you did enjoy this video, and if you did get something out of it, please consider subscribing and smashing that like button. And until the next time everyone, take care.